I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. I just gotta get through, I just gotta get through. Cause I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through.
Sometimes I feel like all is lost, but I know it's not true. I wanna put up all my walls cause I'm not in the mood. But then I cut myself off from the rest of the room. I know that time can heal it all if you're patient and soon.
Welcome back, Real Addict, to another episode. We just got done with the charter. Another successful charter. Thank God for that. If you guys have not checked out those charters I do, check out my website or contact me through Facebook or Instagram. On this week's episode, Radix, I wanted to break down top 5 rods under $100. So if you guys are going out there to purchase your first surf rod or looking to purchase your next surf rod on $100, this video is for y'all. I know it's kind of hard out there to make those choices when you have so many rod options, so this video will definitely help you guys out. Now, before I get started with the video, please help me out. Hit the subscribe button for me. It's a lot of hard work and goes an effort to making these videos, so I really appreciate it. So enough talking. Let's get this breakdown of these top five rods on $100 for y'all. Let's get started with the first choice on my top five. I'm gonna start with a 10-foot rod. And I'm gonna show you guys the difference and the specs on this rod. I've been using this for a rod, like I said. This is an H2O Express 10-foot medium fast action with a stainless steel ceramic insert, so they do last a long time. Actually has from 15 to 30 pounds. The difference between this rod and what I'll get into the next rod, this rod is 10 feet, but it has 5 guides. Medium fast action. I used them about a week ago. Got a ton of whitings on this. Good for its price, like I said, $30. I mean, if you're going out there and you're just getting started or you're intermediate, this is definitely the rod for you to start off with. And the best part about it is the price itself. That's rod number one. Like I said, 10 feet, 50 to 30 pound line, 5 guides, and stainless steel. And the best part, it weighs nothing. Nothing, it's very, very light. So that's rod number one. Now let's get in rod number two. All right, we're getting into the second rod choice. Now this is probably one of my favorite rods. One of my friends gave it to me. This rod is actually $45. You could buy it at Bass Pro or even Amazon. It's called the Power Pro Trophy Class. This is a medium heavy rod. I've caught black tips on this. I caught probably my biggest red drum on this rod. It's a 12-foot Power Plus Trophy Class. Line capacity on this rod is 15 to 50 pounds. So yes, it is also a medium heavy rod. It's a little heavier than the other one. The frame is thicker, so it does hold big fish. Like I said, I caught up to a 6-foot black tip over close to 50 pound red drum. I'll even show at the end how far this rod goes on distance. It has ceramic inserts, 6 guides actually on this rod, and it's 12 feet. It's a good choice that I've had. I had, like I said, every rod that I have here, I've had for over 6 to a year. This rod I've had it for over a year. One of my friends gave it to me. It's a good, really good rod choice. That is rod number two, value at $45. Let's get into the next rod. Now we're getting to our third rod. This rod, I've had it for a year. I have actually have 3 of these. That's how good they are. This is a power heavy action rod. And I'm gonna show you an example why this is a power heavy action rod. This is a 12-foot Brawler Trophy. I bought this rod by accident at Bass Pro Shop. I saw it on special. I wanted to try it out. It's actually done really, really good for me. What I like about this rod on this 12-foot is the tip is ultra sensitive. So if you guys in those pompanos or those whitings or even those big fish that are very finicky, this rod will help you out. Like I said, it's 12 feet long. It has 6 guides, but the best part about it is it has Fuji guides. So they, anybody knows about surf fishing, that Fuji guides on the rod is does help with the distance as far as casting. What else I'm missing? Oh, line capacity from 15 to 50 pounds. We're gonna go ahead and chunk it out. I'm gonna show you guys an example why this rod is such a good rod for its price. Let's get into it and I'll show you right now. I'm gonna show you an example why this is a power fast action rod. 4 feet, Fuji guides, valued at $50. Available at Academy or Bass Pro, even Amazon. I'm gonna chunk it out that you guys tell me where it lands. I'm chunking out a big mullet with a 4 ounce and a 20 pound leader line. Didn't put much effort into it, it traveled far, especially when those reds or black drums are hitting out far in the second sandbar. This rod will help you guys out. So now let's get into the fourth rod choice. All right, we're getting into the fourth rod choice. This is the Shakespeare Tidewater. Line capacity on this rod is 15 to 40 pounds. This is a medium fast action rod, ultra sensitive tips. It has 6 guides. You could chunk on this rod right here, 12 foot rod, you could chunk out from 2 to 5 ounce weight. So it gives you that extra distance. And if it's a rough weather, this rod right here will remain. I've caught big ass fish with this, from reds with sharks to even black drums. And even a red snap, if you guys didn't see that episode, not too long ago. This battery right here is at $50 right now, but they also have a special going on for Valentine's, over $40. You're gonna check them out on Academy or Amazon. Like I said, Shakespeare Tidewater, 12 feet. This one has 6 guides. That is rod number 4. Now let's get into my last rod choice, which is gonna be the Pen Prevail. Let's get into it. Like I said, this is a 12 foot rod. I'm gonna cast it out right quick. I'm using a 6 ounce pyramid. This rod holds very good with these, especially on the rough conditions. God. That right there is a medium fast action Shakespeare Tidewater.
We're down to the last rod. This is probably one of my favorites. I actually just got recently had this one. I've had this one for 4 months. This is a Pen Prevail surf rod, skinny frame. This is an ultra light rod. Actually, it's good for its price, valued at $99. Now let's get into the specifications on the surf rod. This rod, right now, this is my favorite surf rod out of all of them. I have the big Tidewaters, the ugly waters, Akumas out there. I've had them before, but those rods might give me issues, so decided to go purchase this one. The specification is stainless steel guides. 2 to 6 ounces you could chunk out there on pyramid weight. Line capacity, line weight, I mean, you could put up to 15 to 40 pound line on this rod. Extremely light. This is an 11 foot rod with a casting on the bottom to give you the extra casting distance. Ultra light, sensitive, fast action tip, like I said. And this rod has 6 guys standing at 11 feet. I'm gonna chunk it out there so you guys can see. Extremely light, you can catch from a small fish to any type of fish, even shark, black drum, red drum. And I'm gonna chunk it out there for you. That is the 5 rods that I have for y'all by price, by size. This is 11 foot. And let me go ahead and chunk it out there for you guys to see. Type of rod that you could also put a spoon on the surf and keep on casting. Every cast will not get you tired due to its weight, very light. So I hope this episode helped y'all out. We gave you 5 rod choices from 10 to 12 feet and based on prices.
We'll see you guys next week, Radix. Hope this episode helped y'all out. And if you do this channel, welcome.